for Dushyant, we can categorize his looks into three different looks. So he's had a look in the forest, and the second one is the king's look, and the third one is the look that he had for the war. And definitely my aunt has done a fabulous job for the war scene. The harness that he sports is fabulous with lions on the shoulder. That's a must see. And for the forest look, that look is something the audience can vibe more with because it's more wearable, more fresh, and the colors are fabulous. Definitely the king look, I think we'd like to give it a suspense look. It's very bold and very out there and very nice.
Most of her age, like in teens and all that, she was grown up in forest and all that. For the dream songs and all that, we were trying to design something that is related to the forest, like deers or some flowers and all that. But when she, after that, when she comes to the kingdom and when she wears whole jewelry, that was a grand, rich, totally rich jewelry we have given her. And we have given her also three looks. One is in kundan, and one is in diamonds, and one is in gold, apart from the dream songs.
If I may add to this, we believe the hair look, the accessories that went on to the hair for each of Shakuntala's looks are outstanding and amazing. We've given a crown, we've given a hair band, we've given a matapatti. We've done a lot of designing for the hair, and I think the hair pieces are a highlight for each of the three looks mentioned by my aunt right now. And of course, even the dream songs have very dreamy, beautiful jewelry that we can't really imagine. But it's very beautiful. So Menaka's jewelry is actually very beautiful. Since she comes down from heaven, her jewelry had to be very scintillating, very dreamy. And we've done a complete white look for her because that's how she's portrayed in the film. And we've used a lot of stones, white stones, and we've given her a complete shimmer look. And even her hairdo is something noteworthy. A lot of long diamond chains are hanging along her hair, and the complete look with the white hairband and the arm band and the wrist band and everything really makes her very magical on screen.
And her crown is also made in three portions, like three parts. From like Mata Patti till the crown, it's a single piece, but it has three different layers.
And the workmanship, the craftsmanship of putting it together because of the three different layers, it was challenging, but we felt so accomplished and good once we could put that together along with the artisan. So there's a lot of art involved even in the process of the jewelry that we made for the film.
Everything was tough. It's not easy because we are not giving jewelry for the modern age. We have to literally visualize that period, and then we have to think so many angles while doing designing, and technically also. Nothing was easy for me. Everything was tough, and but we enjoyed the journey a lot.
I would say maybe Menaka's jewelry was one point tougher than the rest, because for example, Shakuntala's jewelry, we could take inspiration from the forest, say from animals, birds and trees, but Menaka, coming from heaven, she had to be this dreamy woman, scintillating and shimmering, and we couldn't really use these elements, the floral elements, or we couldn't take animal motifs. So that was a bit challenging, but the output of that, I think, was the most satisfying for us. It was something very bold and nice. We've used different elements. We've used diamonds, we've used kundan, we've used gold, and some of the silver. Yeah, especially for the male jewelry, we've used some silver as well to give that rough old look. We've used different metals.
We are trying to show few jewelry that we used for Dushyant. This is a very beautiful waist belt with big pendants, very nicely designed, and the craftsmanship is totally different and unique. And here we have used a matching for the belt, we have used one neck piece, and even we have given few coral neck chains because back then corals were used most.
Gutta Pusalo is a South design, but it has gained a lot of popularity even in the North and whole of India. And we've created Gutta Pusalo for Dushyant. Although it's considered to be a design for women, we've done it very interestingly for Dushyant. We've given elephant motifs, mango motifs, lotus motifs, and even the size is very variable for today's millennials. And for the top neck piece also, we've given a nut design, a nut that is worn by women as the pendant to make it very interesting and a very different look for King Dushyant.